just start the season when we're down here, so they don't really have sort of the arc for the year. So I don't really know where they're going with her character. It seems to me that every year they kind of build the crescendo is the relationship between the family and the Martinowskis, whether it was our dad this year or the wedding last year, like that's sort of where it goes to. So I know this year it'll be all mom-based and what the, you know, the end-all be-all thing is, I'm not sure. I don't know if he's happy to have mom back or mom is evil and scary.
Yeah. This has been kind of a surreal, I don't know, we don't know if we'll come back from year to year, so we're just so worried about getting back on the air that when we finally do get back on the air, we hear that Linda Hamilton is going to be part of the cast. I mean, for me growing up, if anybody said, listen, you're going to be on the show with Scott Bakula, you know, Chevy Chase, Sarah Lancaster, of course, you're married to Sarah Lancaster, I mean, seriously, dream come true. Just believe kids. It's pretty unbelievable and surreal to have Linda Hamilton because a Terminator, you know, 1 and 2, and just unbelievable for me as a fan. So we get to kind of go along for the same ride that everybody else does here at Comic Con. That we get to do for a job. So it's nice.
There's other
weird
like
ideas
and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Have you even heard about what he's doing
today? Dolph Lundgren? No, I haven't heard anything.
All we've seen is episode 1, so, and Dolph
Lundgren,
and Olivia Munn, like, mm-hmm. episode 1, and a little bit of
And we're pretty much like that couple that's kept in the dark. We're like, you know, if you're not, because we are the couple that's protected in the show from spylight. So they actually try not to tell us too much about the spy world outside of it too. Like, especially me, not very as much, because they're afraid I'll blow it and tell you guys everything. Go out drinking one night and just going, hey, guess who's coming on the show? Ryan, that wasn't supposed to be announced until next week. Whatever. A little tequila, what you can do. So anyhow. You know what, I didn't do that. But, yeah, no. She's seen it now. She's seen it firsthand. I'm trying to wean myself off Cosmos now because she's made fun of me for so long.
I'm trying to find a more manly cocktail.
It's a pretty tasty drink, that's all I'm saying.
Absolutely.
What are we expecting, this season then with Ellie in on the ball?
Ellie's going to have this little baby off.
Yeah, and that's what we're working on. I mean, on the show.
We'll be focused on the family, getting back to some normalcy, and getting back to like being the grounded, as much as I can ground something,
the grounded part of the show is the family life. And, you know, those real moments that I don't think they wanted to get too far away from, you know, that relatable aspect of the show, which are the real challenges of day-to-day life that Ellie and Awesome, I mean, we really got into this mind world, and that was fun and cool, but there's little, like, fights over little stuff, me leaving my spandex on the floor, and stuff like that, we'll get back to, I think, you know?
How bad was it, Ralph?
I know, and it was
I've had to get through life, and it's like everything becomes more heightened, and every little like lack of sleep, every little thing can set you off. So it'll be fun to see if Ellie starts.
I'm hoping that Ellie's horrible at it and awesome at Calgary, and I just can't stand him for it. Like, I'm just sitting
there. Well, don't worry, babe, I'll get you through it.
All right, sorry, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.